Hi, this is Casey Kasem. Well, superstar singer Whitney Houston is just not content having the number one song in the USA. This week, a second Whitney single, I'm Every Woman, leaped 11 big notches to give her the survey's biggest mover as well. Now, will Whitney's latest hit join I Will Always Love You in the top 10? To find out, join us as we count down all the biggest hits in the USA on Casey's Top 40.
Kisses coast to coast.
At number 8 this week is the woman who's been taking the chart by storm for the last 2 years. Since 1985, she's had 6 top 40 hits, including 4 number ones. But not many people know that her first chart single was back in 1984, and it never made the top 40. It was a duet that she sang with Teddy Pendergrass, and here's a piece of it.
Tonight.
Figure out who she was? 1984, Whitney Houston singing on her first chart single with Teddy Pendergrass, Hold Me. It just missed the top 40, peaking at number 46. These days, anything Whitney touches turns into an automatic top 10 hit. Here's her 6th in a row, and it could end up being her 5th number one. Whitney Houston, and Didn't We Almost Have It All?
Casey's biggest hit.
6 years ago this week, back in 1986, one of the biggest hits in the USA was the song about Muhammad Ali that landed Whitney Houston her recording contract. When she sang it for Arista Records, they signed her on the spot. I'll have details and that big hit after this.
Kisses coast to coast.
Falling to number 9 this week is another recent number one song by Whitney Houston. Her 6th number one in only 2.5 years. But you know, back about 7 years ago when she was going to a private girls' school in New Jersey, Whitney's classmates didn't even know she could carry a tune. Whitney says, quote, "None of my friends knew I could really sing. I didn't display the fact that I could sing. I didn't join the glee club and do all that. I just waited until I had the chance to really do it." End of quote. Well, now everybody knows. At number 9, down 7 notches, Whitney. So emotional.
Casey's biggest hits.
6 years ago this week, back in 1986, one of the biggest hits in the USA was the song about Muhammad Ali that landed Whitney Houston a recording contract with Arista Records. It's a song that had been written back in 1977 by Michael Masser and Linda Creed for the soundtrack of the Muhammad Ali documentary, The Greatest. It was one of Whitney's favorite songs. And so when her manager landed her an in-person audition with Arista president Clive Davis, she decided to go with her strongest work. Standing in his office, she sang the song a cappella. And she says she remembers seeing his eyes grow misty. When she finished the song, he signed Whitney right then and there on the spot. And 6 years ago this week, the song that got Whitney her recording contract was one of the biggest hits in the USA. Here's Greatest Love of All.
Kisses coast to coast.
You're hearing the hottest hits across the USA.
Number 16.
Here's the singer who was first signed by her label, Arista Records, when she was 18 years old. But she didn't release her first album till she was 21. She told us, "I took my time. I wanted it to be right." 8 hits later, including 6 number ones, she proved timing is everything. Up 3 notches to number 16, Whitney Houston. And where do broken hearts go?
I know the hits from coast to coast.
Well, now we're up to the young superstar whose mother is also a famous singer. Mom hit the top 40 20 years ago. Listen to this.
I need you here on my mind.
A piece of a song that hit number 18 in March of 1968. The song was Sweet Inspiration by a group called the Sweet Inspirations. They were best known as a studio vocal group backing artists like Aretha Franklin and Elvis Presley. But they also hit the chart on their own. And when the Sweet Inspirations hit the top 40, their lead singer was a woman from New Jersey with a background in gospel music and rhythm and blues. A woman named Sissy, who passed on her musical inspiration to her daughter, Whitney. Whitney says, "I was always proud and aware of our musical tradition, and my mother is a major influence in my career. She's been part of this business for many years, so I get professional advice and motherly guidance." End of quote. Sissy Houston told Time magazine that she coached her daughter from an early age. Quote, "I taught her that in singing, you don't start loud because you have no place to go. I taught her songs tell a story, and you don't blare a story. Control is the basis of singing. Up, down, soft, sweet. End of quote. Whitney really learned her lessons from Mom well. Today, she's the hottest female singer on the charts. Her last 7 chart hits have all gone to number 1. She calls her mother the lady of her life. The latest hit from Sissy Houston's daughter is at number 26 this week on American Top 40. Here's Love Will Save the Day, Whitney Houston. I'm Casey Kasem on Casey's Top 40. Well, now we're up to the latest hit for a superstar whose biggest fan lives in a big white house at 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue. Over the years, a number of past residents of that house have expressed an interest in popular music. Jimmy Carter said many times that he loved the songs of Bob Dylan. Ronald Reagan made no secret of his affection for the singing of Sammy Davis Jr. But the current president, George Bush, hadn't really taken a stand on his favorite act until recently. He finally came out with a position after hearing a superstar sing the national anthem before the start of Super Bowl 25 in Tampa, Florida this year. She gave one of those performances that sends chills up your spine. A performance of the national anthem that ranks among the best of them. Aides to the president said that he was riveted by the performance. It was the best rendition of the song he'd ever heard. He wanted to know all about the singer from New Jersey. And even though he had a lot of things on his mind at the time, he asked one of his aides to pick up all the albums that she had done, which was easy because there are only 3 of them. He also wrote a fan letter to this woman, thanking her for her music and for reminding the country that the Star Spangled Banner can be a great and inspiring song that brings the nation together. Of course, President Bush is just one of many fans this woman has. Fans that have given her 12 top 10 hits. And this week she moves 2 notches closer to her 13th top 10. With survey song number 13 on Casey's Top 40, here's the woman who wowed them at Tampa. The one and only Whitney Houston with Miracle.
How could I throw away
Casey's Top 40?
I'm Casey Kasem. These are the nation's hottest hits by the world's hottest stars. Well, now we're up to the latest hit for a superstar who nearly lost her million-dollar voice when she was a child. This is the chilling story that Whitney Houston told us about the day that almost ended her singing career, years before it ever got started. Whitney was 5 years old at the time, growing up in East Orange, New Jersey. Like a lot of little girls, she was determined to keep up with her older brothers when it came to play. Whitney says one day they were fooling around in the neighborhood playing a children's game called Ring-o-levio, a variation on hide-and-seek that involves taking prisoners. Whitney was running away from one of the pursuers. She scrambled up some rocks, and then she fell and tumbled into a pile of branches. One of the branches, a pointy one, pierced her throat and went into her neck. As you can imagine, Whitney screamed, and her mother, Sissy Houston, came running to see what had happened. Before her eyes was a terrible sight. There was her 5-year-old daughter lying on the ground, writhing in pain. In an instant, Sissy picked up her daughter and found a neighbor to drive them to the nearest hospital. After the doctors examined Whitney, they found that the little girl had been very lucky. The stick had just missed her major arteries, but it had damaged her vocal cords. Had she been older, Whitney probably would have lost her ability to talk normally. But because she was only 5, her body was able to heal itself more easily. In a short time, young Whitney's throat repaired itself, helped along by antibiotics from the doctors. And though Whitney still has a tiny scar on her neck as a reminder of that accident, her singing is as pure as could be. This week, the voice that almost wasn't is singing survey song number 26 on Casey's Top 40. Here's the very lucky and very talented Whitney Houston with her 14th Top 40 hit, a song called My Name Is Not Susan.
Casey's biggest hit.
10 years ago this week, one of the biggest hits in the USA was the only one of Whitney Houston's 11 number ones to feature her famous mother singing backup. I'll have details and that big hit after this.
Casey's Top 40.
I'm Casey Kasem. Well, now we're up to the brand new number one song in the USA on Casey's Top 40. And it's a record breaker. The fastest rising number one song of the past 20 years. The road to the top of the chart isn't always a smooth one. And sometimes it takes as much as 3 months for a song to rise to number one. But every once in a while, a hit comes along that causes a sensation. That's what happened back in 1985 when 46 stars got together here in Hollywood to help save the starving people of Africa. The song they recorded that magical night hit the chart in March of 85. And in 4 short weeks, it went to number one, becoming the fastest rising number one of the 80s. That song was We Are the World by the group USA for Africa. Then earlier this year, a hit came along to tie that record. It was by a controversial singer, dancer, and actress, a woman who co-starred in the movie A League of Their Own. When a song she did for that film hit the pop chart, it tied the record set by We Are the World, also soaring to number one in 4 short weeks. That song, This Used to Be My Playground, by Madonna. Well, now another woman's come along to break that record. And her song is also from a movie she stars in. It's her very first movie. She plays the part of a famous singer. And Kevin Costner plays the man whose job it is to protect her, the bodyguard. 2 weeks ago, a song she sings in The Bodyguard entered the survey at number 23. Last week, it soared to number 9. And now, in only its 3rd week on the chart, it leaps from number 9 all the way to number 1, making it the fastest rising number 1 song of the past 20 years. The brand new number 1 song in the USA on Casey's Top 40 is I Will Always Love You by Whitney Houston.
Casey's biggest hits.
10 years ago this week, one of the biggest hits in the USA was the only one of Whitney Houston's 11 number ones to feature her famous mother singing backup. Whitney's mother, of course, is gospel singer Sissy Houston, who was with the Drinkard Singers and who sang backup for Elvis Presley and Aretha Franklin as one of the Sweet Inspirations. And Sissy had long been a sweet inspiration to her daughter, Whitney. So much so that when she was recording her first album, she insisted her mother be part of it. And so if you listen carefully, you can hear Sissy Houston in the background of the smash that was one of the biggest hits in the USA 10 years ago this week. Here are Whitney and Sissy Houston with How Will I Know?
I know he's the one I dream of. How will I know if he's thinking of me? I try the phone, but I'm too shy. I can't speak. Falling in love is so bittersweet. This love is strong. Why do I feel weak?
Casey's Coast to Coast. Casey's Top 40.
Well, now we're up to the song, I Have Nothing. It's by a 29-year-old woman who has everything. An award-winning superstar who last year added a new title to the many she's won. Like a number of pop artists, the quick rise of her career, first as a model and as a singer, kept this woman from New Jersey from getting a college degree. Things were happening so fast she felt she had to follow her destiny, and she says she's always regretted not having finished college. But last year, she managed to satisfy that desire in a way. You see, she was contacted by the faculty of one of the most prestigious black institutions of higher education in America, Grambling University. They told her they wanted her to speak at their graduation ceremony, and they wanted to award her an honorary doctorate in humanities in gratitude for the wonderful music she'd given to the world over the years. Smashes like Greatest Love of All, One Moment in Time, and Miracle. Well, the superstar says she was overwhelmed by the honor and deeply touched, which is why one day last June, Whitney Houston walked up to the podium at Grambling University dressed in cap and gown. She addressed the students and graciously received her honorary degree. This week, Whitney Houston, or should we say Dr. Whitney Houston, leaps 7 notches to number 26 on Casey's Top 40 with her latest musical thesis. From the soundtrack of the movie The Bodyguard, here's one of the songs nominated for the Academy Award for Best Original Song, I Have Nothing.
American Top 40. This star is 29 now, but she was only 12 when she started singing in her mom Sissy's nightclub act. Holding at number 3 on American Top 40, it's Whitney Houston.
Well, now we're up to the song Exhale. It's by a deeply religious superstar who says when things go bad, her faith lifts her up. And when things go well, her faith brings her down to earth. Whitney Houston says that without her strong religious background, she just wouldn't be who she is today. And she explained what she means by that in a recent in-depth interview in Vibe magazine. Whitney told Vibe, quote, I'm happy just knowing that I have God in my life. I was raised on the Word, raised to practice it. It's about believing when you don't have anything to believe in. And Whitney says that belief has kept her going when times have been tough. And the superstar singer says God also helps her when she's on top. Quote, it's by His mercy that I'm here. I'm not perfect. I'm not beyond anybody else. I'm just a child of God. Everything I have is no more than what God gave me. Unquote. This week, Whitney's using her God-given talents on the song that moves up 3 notches to number 15 on Casey's Top 40. Here's Whitney Houston and Exhale.
Everyone falls.
Casey's Top 40.
Well, now we're up to I Believe in You and Me, the first hit from the film The Preacher's Wife, a movie that was plagued by one production disaster after another. It's not unusual for a major motion picture to encounter problems in the course of its production, but in the case of The Preacher's Wife, starring Denzel Washington and Whitney Houston, those production problems seemed endless. As Entertainment Weekly pointed out, it seemed more like an episode of The X-Files than a Christmas movie about goodness and gospel music. The problems included shooting during one of the worst winters on record, when one day of production after another was lost thanks to an endless series of snowstorms. Then, when the film headed for normally frigid Portland, Maine to shoot a scene at an outdoor ice skating rink, things suddenly warmed up, so much so that the ice melted, ruining the scene. During a scene in Yonkers, New York, an adjacent building caught fire, stopping production. Crew members say they began to feel as if they were under a dark cloud. But in the end, the film did get made and became one of the biggest hits of the holiday season. At number 32 on Casey's Top 40, here's the first hit from the soundtrack of The Preacher's Wife, I Believe in You and Me by Whitney Houston.
American Top 40.
I'm Ed McMahon, in this week for Casey Kasem. We're playing the biggest hits in the USA by the biggest stars in the world. Whitney Houston is a star who's expanding her horizons. She recently announced that she bought the rights to The Princess Diaries, a book about a 16-year-old girl who discovers that she's the princess of a small European country. Whitney's company will be making it into a movie, and she'll serve as the film's producer. Slipping 2 notches to number 24, here's movie producer and megastar Whitney Houston with It's Not Right, But It's Okay.
The hits from